The threat of blue-green algae was highlighted this past week in Toledo, where nearly a half million people were told to stay away from tap water because of toxins produced by the algae growing in Lake Erie, the city's water source. So when Lake Champlain is plagued by the same kind of bacteria, does our drinking water become threatened?
We don't believe it could happen very likely here in Champlain Water District.
Michael Mersatti is the director of water quality and production at the Champlain Water District.
Clean, clear water.
The operation filters about 10 million gallons per day to supply water to customers in the greater Burlington area.
The reason he's so confident in the quality of the district's water has to do with something that's about a half mile offshore beneath the surface here in Shelburne Bay.
We built a new intake, a redundant intake out into Lake Champlain. It's 2,500 feet out into the lake at 75 feet of depth.
That's where the district draws the raw water out of Lake Champlain before bringing it into the filtration system. He says the depth of the intake makes all the difference.
The benefit is that algae, any kind of algae, tends to be on the surface of the water. So the deeper you are away from the surface of the water, less likely the algae is going to have any kind of an impact.
Lake advocates say outside the district, plants that draw water from shallower depths might not be so well off. In addition, they say monitoring of blue-green algae should be better.
We seem to be content as a culture to monitor and just watch these things, almost as if we're looking in our rearview mirror at a car accident. We need to be looking out the windshield and thinking about how we can prevent these things from happening down the road.